Well, doctors have been seeing COVID impact athletes' hearts in a few ways. Joining us now to shed light on these developments is Dr. Paul D. Thompson, Chief of Cardiology Emeritus, Hartford Hospital. Doctor, welcome.
Thanks, Lisa.
Thanks for being with us. All right, so what kind of cardiac after effects are you seeing as a result of COVID?
So actually, we're not seeing much in athletes as a cardiac after effect, but here's the sources of worry. About 20% of the people in Wuhan who got sick and were hospitalized had cardiac abnormalities, making us very worried about something called myocarditis. And myocarditis simply means an inflammation of the heart, concern that the virus affected the heart. Subsequent studies out of Germany said that a lot of people, 60 days later, had evidence of myocarditis, and there are a bunch of studies suggesting that it may happen in athletes. So that's the source of concern. But frankly, many of us who do this work, who work with athletes, haven't found much. So the question is, how much is real and how much is just worry?
All right. What is your advice to parents of student athletes? What should they look out for?
So my advice to the parents of student athletes is that if the child had mild COVID, not to worry very much. If they're concerned, check it out with the primary care doctor. If, however, the athlete returns to competition and either does not practice and does not have good exercise tolerance or has symptoms of shortness of breath or chest discomfort, then again, get it checked out. We don't think that every athlete needs to have an extensive workup. That was the initial recommendation, but those initial recommendations have been toned down because we haven't seen a lot of a problem.
All right, and when should an athlete be seen by a cardiologist?
An athlete should be seen by a cardiologist if either the parents are very worried, because we want to make sure that parents aren't unnecessarily worried, or if the primary care physician thinks that a kind of an upward referral is necessary.
All right, and people can learn more at hartfordhealthcare.org. Dr. Paul Thompson, thank you very much for joining us. We appreciate your time.
Thanks for having me, Lisa.
Thank you.